Today we are going to see about J.D. Hope, famous poem, The Death of the Bird. J.D. Hope was written The Death of the Bird. It is a famous poem. We'll see the poem. So it is a long poem and written by an Australian poet. So J.D. Hope is an Australian poet. This poem is a very, very famous poem. We can see the post-colonialism theme and then the nature theme and how they have written this poem in a different manner. So the poem is a deals with the idea of death against the vast indifference of the universe. So when we read the poem, we can see. So the poem is divided into eight stanza. Each stanza contains four lines. So it was written in an alternate rhyme. So we can see the rhyme scheme, that is A, B, A, B. Like that only the poem goes when we take each and every stanza. Okay, we'll go to the poem. First paragraph. For every bird, there is this last migration. Once more the cooling air kindles a heart with a warm passage to the summer station. Love pricks the course in lights across the chart. So here we can see the poem is about the bird. The poem is about the bird. For every bird, see, when we see the bird, usually the bird will migrate from one place to another. One place to another. So it will go from one place to another. So this poem is, it is a 8 stanza, but it is a 9 stanza. The poem has a 9 stanza. And we can see how the bird migrate. Usually when we see the bird from one place to, it comes to the another place. The migration is nothing but a person or a bird, animal, it goes from one place to another, that is a migrated. Once more the cooling air kindles a heart. So if it is a cooling, if it comes a cooling air, sure that bird will migrate from one place to another to get a warm and to have a food. If it is a cold, means it can't go and search the food. So it will go for the warm place, that is a warm passage, is nothing but a warm path to the summer station. So it will search for the summer station, the season of the summer where the sun comes. So it goes there. Love pricks the course in the light across the chart. It always go for those places. So the poet is talking about a bird towards the end of her life. It is a migratory bird who moves seasonally from one place to another. For what? In search of food and to have a warm. So because it is a winter season, so it goes in search of summer station because it loves only the summer. So she remembers the course in light. It is nothing but entire navigation details. How he come, how that bird comes and how it goes. These are the thing. The course in light is nothing but the passage, what it across the chart of his own life. Okay, now for second paragraph, second stanza. Here after year, a speck on the map, divided by a whole hemisphere, summons her to come, season after season, sure and safely guided. Going away, she is also coming home. So in second stanza, the author is explaining about every year it goes from one place to one place. It is like a speck on the map. It is like a speck on the map is nothing but a spot, a tiny spot. Speck means a tiny spot. When we see the map, in the map we can see a small pot. Spot like a country will be there, like a regions will be there. So same way, that divided by a whole hemisphere. So those country, for example, India, Africa, South Africa, these are divided by the hemispheres. Hemisphere is nothing but the line, how it divides the, in map we can see. So all that hemisphere, the whole hemisphere, for example, the bird is living in this country now, India, means when we take a whole hemisphere, now it is a half, next to, opposite to our, when we see the globe, no? When you can imagine the globe, now we are in India. So it, when it goes opposite to the another side of the hemisphere, means it is some other place. So that bird will search like that. That place summons her to come. Summons is nothing but calling her to come. Whom? The bird. So the, even the hemisphere, that is nothing but a season. The changes of the season, it is also summons her to come. Season after season, sure and safely guided. So it, the, because of season after season, because of the season, no, the season, it also carries her to like a guide, safely guided, going away, she is also coming home. So it goes, and actually it is also coming to their, returning to the home. So in this passage, when we see, it is a predetermined place. So here the poet is speaking about how the another hemisphere, that is the other half of the earth. For example, if it is in this earth, means next to us, it is the another half of the earth. And then she has gone there so many times, that is her other home. What looks like going away is actually in a way of coming home. Next, third stanza. And being home, memory because, sorry, and being home, memory becomes a passion with which she feeds her brood and straws her nest, aware of ghosts that haunt the heart's possession and exile love mourning within the breast. So here the poet, the bird thinks himself that, and being a home, memory becomes a passion. Wherever it goes, wherever the bird fly, no, always in his mind, the passion, the memory of the passion. The passion is nothing but what is work with which she feeds her brood and straws her nest. So that bird, after giving a birth to the little one, it feeds her brood and straws her nest. With the straws, it built the nest. Aware of ghosts that haunted the heart's passion and exile love mourning within the breast. So, and then that bird is thinking himself that memory of the past, how it builds the house, how she built the house and how she feeds the little ones. It all comes like a ghost. It all comes like a ghost. So here the poet is telling that the memory, comparing the memory to the ghost. Memory to the ghost. So an exile love mourning within the breast, because now that bird is mourning because of that memory, remembering those days, it mourns. The bird mourns. In this stanza, after migrating, the memory of the earlier place becomes a passion with which she feeds her young babies and build the nest with the straws. But the memory from one place to another place, that memory, it comes after coming from one place to another place, the memory is like a ghost. It is haunting in her heart. In her heart, and her love to come back again is termed as exiled love. Okay, next, fourth stanza. In fourth stanza, we can see how the image of illusory is followed by the poet. The sands are green with a myriad of valleys. The palm tree cast a shadow, not its own, down the long architrave of temple or palace blows a cool air from moorland scarps of stone. So here, almost from the point of view of a bird, the poet is trying to show how the mourning in the bird has caused her to see the mirage. That is, mirage is nothing but illusion of valleys on the sands. Perhaps it is a desert, because now it is a desert, it is a valley, it is a desert only. In a desert area only we can see the palm tree. The image given in this stanza is illusory, as the palm tree's shadow is different from the way it should be. She is feeling the cold air coming out of the molding. That is, the architrave is nothing but a molding around the doors of the temple or palace. So it comes there from the moorland, from the temple, from the palace, the cool air along with the door, it comes, the cool air comes, because in desert it can't see the cold air, but from the temple, from palace only, because it is all built like that, so from there only the cool air is coming. Okay, next stanza, fifth stanza. Next, fifth stanza. And day by day the whisper of love grows stronger, that delicate voice more urgent with despair, custom and fear constraining her no longer, drives her at last on the waste leagues of air. So here the poet is telling that day by day it whispers of love grow stronger, because to come, that is summoning, to go from one place to another, it is like a that love grows stronger, that with that delicate voice, that is a more urgent with despair. So that bird want to go, the is very urge to go to that place, from one place to another place, but custom and fear constraining her no longer. So it continues that it something is restricting her. Because of the fear and because of the custom, it got some fear whether I can go or not. I can go, move from one place to or not. Like that, that bird is going on fearing herself. But now, no longer, I never have a fear in my mind. Sure, I must go from this place. So, drives her at last on the waste leagues of the air. So, it decided to go away from this. Slowly the call to go to the other place grows stronger in the bird, so she can't resist it anymore. The feeling was delicate, but now it is full of despair. So it feels so urgent now that she is able to cancel the comfort and the fear which were stopping her. She finally decided into the waste leagues, that is an early way of measuring a variable distance of air. It seems like the poet anticipates her journey as a wastage, so she want to go from one place to another place. Next is the sixth paragraph. A vanishing speck in those in end dominions, single and frail, uncertain of her place, alone in the bright host of her companions, lost in the blue unfriendliness of space. So here the poet is telling about how the bird now looks. How the bird now it looks. A vanishing speck. Speck is nothing but a spot in those in end dominions. In end means whether they are not understand anything, that is a lacking sense. So it, which means what, maybe it is a weak or a not able to think properly. That is a single and frail, uncertain of a place, alone in the bright host of a companions, lost in the blue unfriendliness of space. So what happened when it goes? So, because of that, unnoticingly, because of his not able to thinking power, it goes alone. There is no companion, bright host of her companions. That is, only alone, that bird only, it moves from one place to another place. None of them or there, lost in a blue unfriendliness of a space is nothing but only the sky is there. That sky is not a good companion. It is also not a companion because unfriendliness, it is not a friendly one. Only the sky is there and this bird alone passes from one place to another. That is a migrate from one place to another. There is a nothing. Because it is a very stupid thing, isn't it? When we see, when the bird comes from one place to another, only it comes as a group, not as a single one. I think we all know, in sky we used to see many, for example, or five or six only it moves. Not in one single bird or a two bird, it never comes, isn't it? So, but this vanishing speck, because it doesn't have any sense, because of the lacking sense, it did like this. The poet is hinting at the sky through the metaphor of blue uncleanness of space. So here, the metaphor used by the poet in the fourth line. And in the next stanza, seventh stanza, she feels it close now, the appointed season. The invisible thread is broken as she flies. Suddenly, without warning, without reason, the guiding spark of instant winks and dies. So she feels it closed now. Now she's feeling it is closed now. And the appointed season. So it can't reach the season because the invisible thread which it passes, that bird passes because of the thread, which means what I already informed, the season, passing of the season. It gives like a path from one place to another place, but it invisibly, the thread is broken and she flies, even though it flies, but suddenly, without warning, without reason, the guiding spark of instinct winks and dies. So without any instant, without any warning, because the thread which carries her, it now becomes a invisible. So it couldn't pass from one place to another. It couldn't fly. So without any warning, without a reason, it winks and it dies. The bird dies because of no one to carry her. The invisible thread is broken, so that the bird, now it guiding spark of instinct wings and dies. It dies. So the bird has traveled far. She can sense that the season for which she came is somewhere nearby. Suddenly something long has happened. Due to her weakness, that invisible thread that was guiding her path is broken. So here the poet is describing the tragedy which has happened to the bird without any warning or reason. It is an instinct that navigates a bird, and in this case, it has died suddenly. Next, eighth stanza. Try as she will, the trackless world delivers. No way, the wilderness of light, no sign. The immense and complex map of hills and rivers mocks her small wisdom with its vast design. So here the poet is telling about the world. So try as she will. So the bird has tried, but it couldn't find a path, because the world become a what? It becomes a very, very complex. Because no way, the wilderness of light and no sign. There is a no sign to that bird. And then the poet is telling that the world, that is he mocking the world, that what? That immense and complex maps of hills and rivers mocks a small wisdom. See, that bird, it has only a small wisdom. But the world is a very, very vast design. So here the poet is telling the world is mocking the bird, because with this the geographical and the earth and the map, which is so long, isn't it? Hills, rivers, and so many things we have. You are a vast world, you are a vast, but you have tested the small amount of bird, that it has a small wisdom. You mocks her, like that the poet is telling. So the bird is trying her best to find a way, but the whole world has suddenly become a trackless Without instinct, the light has also become a wilderness. Without any sign to a guide, the poet has described the vast geography of this earth, which is very complicated. Its design is so vast that it makes fun of the bird's small wisdom, because the world is mocking the small wisdom. It is testing the small wisdom of the bird. The last stanza, ninth stanza, and darkness rises from the eastern valleys, and the wind buffeted her with the hungry breath. And the great earth, with neither grief nor malice, receives the tiny burden of her death. So the poet is pointing towards the direction here. The eastern valley is nothing but the from the eastern direction, from which the darkness is rising for the bird, who has just lost her way. The bird who has just lost her way. The winds are striking her. Buffet is nothing but a blowing the air, striking her forcefully in a way like they are angry. That the breathing is very, very angry. It ultimately kills the bird. The force of the earth, it ultimately kills the bird. So the earth, which is so great, feels no grief for any death. It doesn't even threaten anyone's life intentionally. It is simply indifferent. That is, the earth is simply indifferent because it is a great earth, but it doesn't have any grief or a malice. Malice is nothing but making a fear. That is, it will cause a harm. Receives the tiny burden of her death. So the death of the bird is but a tiny burden on the earth. It receives her body indifferently. So, it receives the tiny burden of her death. So it is a very, very tiny thing. For earth, the death of the bird is a very, very tiny thing. It is a very, very tiny thing. It is the clear explanation of the death of the bird poem by A.D. Hope. If you like this explanation, kindly like and share among your friends. And if you are seeing the first time the video, kindly subscribe the video and click the notification bell to have new poem. Thank you for watching and thank you for spending your valuable time.